गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी कॉमर्स। इन कॉमर्स वी विल सी चैप्टर 4 बैंकिंग लेटेस्ट ट्रेंड्स। सो एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट यू विल हैव टू सपोज योर सेल्फ एज अ बिजनेसमैन। सो इन फर्स्ट चैप्टर यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट। एट दैट टाइम यू हैव टू जस्ट गेट द आइडिया अबाउट योर बिजनेस। आफ्टर दैट इन सेकेंड चैप्टर यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट कैपिटल विच रिक्वायर्ड इन योर बिजनेस। Then in third chapter you have studied that how you will accumulate your capital, from which types of sources, from where you will accumulate your capital. In third chapter you have studied this. Now in fourth chapter you will see that how you will means make payment and how you will receive payment from customers and from other business in your business. So means how you will perform business transactions in your business without any risk, because you know that in business most of the transactions we are means completing, we are finishing in only online. So that is why there are certain types of methods which I am going to tell you, that in your business you can use these types of methods for making a payment or receiving a payment without any risk. So you can just see here, real time gross settlement means RTGS. RTGS is a very popular method for making a payment in a business. So you can see here, it is a fund transfer system under which transfer of funds take place from one bank to other bank. Means from one bank to other bank you can make payment to anyone, to any company or any individual person, and it will not take very long time, but as you will make a payment, the customer or receiver, they will receive the payment. So this is the RTGS. Next, features of RTGS. RTGS is not available at all the banks branches, means in only those types of banks, those who are having only RTGS facility, you can just make payment from that bank only. And the minimum amount in RTGS is 2 lakhs. Minimum amount 2 lakhs, you can make payment minimum 2 lakhs. But now it has changed. You can make payment for any other types of transactions. And now, next is the receiver or beneficial bank must credit the customer's account from customer's account within 2 hours. Next is the fourth is fee charge for RTGS transaction vary from bank to bank. Means the bank is, they are taking some types of commission. If you are making payment through the RTGS, so they are receiving some types of commission. So this is different types of commission, different types of bank they are receiving. This is bank to bank. Now, National Electronic Fund Transfer System, NEFT. You would have listened about NEFT. This is the National Electronic Fund Transfer System. You can also use this method for making payment in your business. So what is this? This is a countrywide system by which an individual or firm or company can transfer funds from any bank branch to another individual, firm or company. So you can also make payment to any individual or any firm or any company through this method. This is the, you can say, NEFT. Now e-banking, everybody knows you now, because this is the time in this modern era we are using net banking, and we are also using e-marketing. So e-marketing with your mobile or with your computer, you are using e-marketing. So this is called e-marketing. E-banking we can also use. So electronic banking is banking over the internet. Simply what means, while you are using your internet for making any types of transactions or for receiving or giving any types of transactions, so that is called e-banking. And the main forms of electronic banking are as follows. So first is the EFTs. These are the different types of method which we are using in e-banking. So first is the electronic fund transfer system, EFTs. Under this system, money can be transferred from one account to another account. For example, a bank transfer wages, salary. You know that now government made a rule that every worker, every labor, every employee, they will get salary or wages in their accounts only if they are not casual. They are regular. If they are regular worker, they are regular employee, so they will get salary in their account. So this method is used by many types of companies, firms and other types of organizations. They are paying wages, salaries and other types of payment to the workers or employees. Next is the automatic teller machine, ATM. Everybody, you know about ATM. So here there is one thing I would like to tell you, that sometimes what happened, that confusion create because of ATM card and ATM machine. So in your board examination, you'll have to just keep this thing in your mind, that you'll have to see that what is ATM card and what is ATM machine. Here we are talking about ATM machine, means automatic teller machine. So you know that what is ATM machine. Simply, with this, any individual can withdraw money from the ATM. This is the facility for 24 hours. You can use this facility 24 hours and you can withdraw your money from your ATM. And also now you can get facility for depositing your money. You can go to the ATM and you can also deposit your money. So this is the ATM. Next is the debit card. Now debit card, you know, debit card is a ATM card. Debit card, when you can get debit card, if you are having an account in your bank, so you can get debit card. But there is one thing, that whatever amount you have deposited in your bank, only equal to that amount you can use your debit card, or you can withdraw money from the ATM machine by using of your debit card. But certain amount of you of certain amount of money should be deposited in your bank account. So according to the limit of your account, you can withdraw money, and you can also make payment of for many types of goods and services. Now next is the credit card. Now there is a one difference between credit card and debit card. Credit card, if you are having a good position, if you are having a good reputation in the bank, only then you can get credit card from the bank. And this is also, you can say that there is a overdraft facility in the credit card, means no need for limited amount in your account, in your bank account, but you can withdraw over money, means excess money you can withdraw from your account. So this is the credit card. Next is the telebanking. Telebanking means to say that this method was using before few years, and there was a computer in the individual hands, and it was connected with the bank, and through this computer they were getting many types of information about the bank account from the bank. Time to time bank, they were sending many types of information in the personal computer of any individual. Now next is the core banking system, means CBS. Under this system, customer becomes customers of the bank rather than customer of a branch. By opening a bank account in one branch which has CBS facility, you can use this facility in any types of banks, no matter you are having account in that branch or not. But in India, you can use any bank which enables CBS branch. So this facility is also for making payment and receiving payment for the individual or for the firms. Now next is the SMS alert. SMS alert means, you know, under this service, customer gives his or her mobile number. The bank records the mobile number in its computer system in the customer's account. Whenever there is a transactions, debit or credit will be there in your account, bank will send SMS to you, and you can get information about your account. Suppose if you will go to the ATM and you will withdraw some money, so bank will send you information about your account, that much amount, that much money deducted from your account. So this is the SMS alert. Now next is the bank draft. You know that bank draft and bank overdraft, there are two types of different types of things, you'll have to just remember. Now bank draft we are talking here. So bank draft means to say that we can say that this is a check, but this is for third party, and first you'll have to make payment and you'll have to purchase this bank draft from the bank. You can also make this bank draft for same bank or another bank. For any individual, you can purchase this bank draft. So you'll have to make a certain amount to the bank, and after that you can take a bank draft, and bank will also take some commission. Whatever amount you are paying for the bank draft, you'll have to pay some extra amount for the commission of the bank. So this is the bank draft. So these are some types of methods which you can use while you are making payments or you are receiving payments in your business. So now you'll have to see it at your home, and thank you very much.